Our American-made company today makes what is considered to be the most popular snack food in the world. You might have it strung on your Christmas tree. Ron Israel is co-founder of Doc Popcorn. He joins us now. Good morning, Ron. How are you?
Hi, guys. It's actually Rob Israel, but great to be with you this morning.
Isn't it great? Sorry.
No problem.
So in 3 years, I always thought Orville Redenbacher would be hard to pass. And then I actually thought of Orville Redenbacher, and I thought he had a sweater. The pictures of Orville Redenbacher, where he looked really silly, he had the same sweater. But how did you, if you had glasses on, you could
play
with Orville. Orville wore a bow tie.
Got to age up a little bit.
Orville wore a bow tie, right, and a red sweater. So in three years, I mean, that's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been a pretty amazing ride. You know, my wife and I, Renee, founded the company in 2003. We left your area, moved out to Boulder, Colorado, the kind of mecca of food, and then started franchising just in 2009. And in those 3 years, we've become the largest popcorn retailer literally in the world, and it's just been an amazing, exciting ride.
So you're based in Boulder?
We are based in Boulder, Colorado, and we have now 300 locations in development, 85 units open and popping as of the end of the year. So we're in 30 states and passing out smiles and great product to folks all over this beautiful country.
Are you out near like Celestial Seasonings or in Boulder?
Yeah, you know, our office is pretty close to there. You know the area?
I went to school there and I took a tour of Celestial Seasoning. Next time we're going to take a tour of Doc Popcorn.
We got to get you in and popping, absolutely. And hopefully you guys will be indulging a little bit later with all those flavors that are sitting on your desks out there. So, yeah.
I'm going to tell you, we have a famous former CEO, maybe the most famous one in the world, I'm not going to mention who he is, who sends popcorn to some of his favorite people. And my wife loves it and says, I eat it, but the caramel popcorn, she says, if you eat that, you're insane because how fattening is caramel popcorn? Because that's what you loved, and that was your idea, to figure out a way to make it where it's just not like death, right?
Yeah, exactly right. And the idea was to make it a more indulgent, more edible, infinitely edible snack. Ours is grab and go, quick serve, and we do it very differently. You know, you just hit on one of the keys. There's movie theater popcorn on one end of the spectrum, and then there's this heavily coated, heavily candy product on the other side. We are very different than that. We use all natural products. We use corn oil. We infuse all of our popcorn with these amazing ingredients, the finest spices literally in the world, the finest cheeses, but it's light. People come to our mall stores, they will literally buy a bag, eat it, and buy another bag. So it isn't that really heavy, product. It's something that's much lighter and more indulgent.
As an aside, in a big bucket, let's say you load up the butter at a movie theater, you're talking like 1,500, 2,000 calories, aren't you? I mean, it's like,
yeah,
you might not even make it out of the theater, but your heart might explode.
For that type of popcorn, that's the issue, and that's kind of what that's why we've exploded, because we've done this so differently. And people try our product, and they're like, wow, this is really different. This is really amazing, you know?
Are your franchisees having a hard time getting credit we hear about so much? Does that need to...
It's a good point. We would like, you know, the credit markets were very liberal, as everyone knows, and they really got very unbelievably constricted. I think we're sitting, hopefully we'll get somewhere in the middle soon. It would be better, certainly, if we call them pop proprietors, by the way, and they're awesome. I just want to shout out to them because they're out there in the field, bringing our brand to folks, serving up smiles every day, giving out bags of Doc Popcorn. So I just want to—they've been getting some credit lately, but it has been a bit constricted.
Oh, it's great. You're hiring a lot of—you know—you're creating jobs. This is the way it's supposed to be done. And biggest popcorn retailer in the world.
I don't know how you
did
this though.
Huh?
I don't really still understand how this happened.
It's like healthier.
And it's gluten-free, and it's in Boulder. Which is the big
thing. Yeah, and you know, I think the other part of that is that if you think about what's happened in the world of food commodities, and I know you guys are talking about that, you know, in the 50s, McDonald's came around and did hamburgers differently. And then Starbucks came around and did coffee unbelievably. And Auntie Anne's, our friends at Auntie Anne's, they did something very amazing with pretzels. We're doing the same thing with popcorn. We've made it a simple business model, efficient, affordable, fun.
Did you think it could be this big when you started?
You know, that was the dream, but it took us 6 years to really figure it out. I thought it was going to happen overnight. I mean, we often say, you know, it's 10 years to an overnight success. We learned and explored and figured this out, and then we rolled out franchising, and then because we'd done that homework and done that learning, it really happened big. Mm-hmm. But it took a little bit longer than we thought, to be honest.
Can we get it in New York City?
You can get it in Paramus. You can get it. We're opening up all over New York. We're looking in New York City right now. We also are at the Palisades Mall, so we're dotted all around you. We're going to hopefully, and you can order it online anytime. But hopefully we'll get very soon in the city.
Good.
And Renee, your wife's name is Renee, right? And
she is
we
Renee.
Get that one right? All right, excellent.
You got that. Yeah, that was spot on, and that was awesome.
That's good. I appreciate it. Thanks. Rob, thanks. We appreciate it. Thanks for...
You guys are great. Thanks for having us, and happy holidays.
You
and,
too.
I just want to say that, you know, it's America's an awesome, amazing place. I know things are tough, have been tough. And there's a lot of kind of back and forth about politics, but it's pretty amazing the opportunities that we all get here, and we've been dreaming big, and
mm-hmm.
That's great. And it's been awesome.
And you also you live where there's 300 days of sunshine a year, so
a lot of folks know that too.
I'd be in a good
snow
mood
in the
too.
Mountains.
Boulder is heaven. It is.
You
it's the
were
greatest
smart
place.
Smart to go to school there. I wish I did. You
the
know?
Greatest place. All right, we'll be out there in March. Maybe we'll stop by and take a tour.
We would love to see you, and we so appreciate this opportunity to be with you guys.
Okay, Rob. See you later. Thanks.
Okay. Coming up, attention.